Hello, fellow brawlers. I'm Kairos Time. It's time to talk about some balance changes. Let's start off with the brawlers that are getting buffs, but I wanted to remind you that I'll be releasing other update sneak peeks, so if you haven't already subscribed and turned on that notification bell so you actually get notified, now would be a great time for you guys to do that. Penny is getting a 6% buff to her health. At max level, it's increasing from 4,480 to 4,760 HP. For reference, this is actually the same HP as Colette and Griff, and this will help Penny survive one more ammo from 10 out of the 50 brawlers in the game after Ash was released, of course. This really isn't a huge buff to Penny, but I do think it'll be enough to make her a bit more useful since she's kind of struggling and has been for a while. Daryl is also getting a 6% health buff. At max level, he's going from 7,000 HP to 7,420 health, which is just a little bit less than what Rosa has. This will allow Daryl to survive one more ammo from 13 of the 50 brawlers in the game. Because Daryl actually has so much health to begin with, this is actually a pretty significant buff. I don't expect him to take over the meta, but I could see him becoming more useful in Heist and maybe also a couple other places as well. Edgar is getting a significant buff to his lifesteal. It is going from 25% lifesteal to 35% lifesteal with his attack. That's an additional 150 health healed from one ammo, which I actually think is a pretty sizable buff. I'm not certain yet, but I think this is going to allow Edgar to be a lot more useful, although he's obviously not going to be as strong as he used to be. Squeak is getting three very solid buffs. First of all, his attack projectile speed is being buffed by 25%. You can see in this clip right here how much of a difference this will actually make it for Squeak. And the great thing about this is that it's going to make it easier for Squeak to actually land shots and will be much more difficult for enemies to dodge them. The second buff is to his super. It is now going to split as soon as the super hits the ground rather than having a delay. The airtime will be constant no matter where you throw it, just like it always has been, but enemies will now have much less time to run away, which means that Squeak's super should deal damage more consistently. Now, on top of all that, his attack is getting another buff. If Squeak's attack hits a target who already has a Blom attack stuck to them, the previous Blom will explode. This won't change anything if the Bloms don't actually get stuck to the target, like if they just blow up to the side of the brawler, but in those cases where Squeak does land his shots, Squeak will be able to deal damage a bit faster to enemies. I'm not expecting any of these three individual buffs to make Squeak very strong, but I have a feeling that he might actually be useful after this update. Bo is getting a 7% buff to his attack damage. At max level, the damage that each arrow deals is increasing from 754 to 840 damage. This is going to allow Bo to kill 12 out of the 50 brawlers in the game with one less ammo, but even more significant than that is that almost every single brawler in the game will die if they get hit by one less arrow from Bo than they would have before the update. I'm actually excited to see if this makes Bo more viable, especially because his super totem gadget has been nerfed into oblivion, and the only other reason people have been playing him is for his circling eagle star power. Poco is getting two buffs, and the first is to his screeching solo star power. The damage from it is increasing from 800 to 1000 damage, which is honestly actually pretty sizable. In fact, a lot of pros have been saying that screeching solo has been fairly good recently, which tells me that more and more people will probably use it even though Poco's Da Capo star power is so strong. Po's second buff is to his protected tunes gadget. The duration of the immunity from adverse effects is increasing from 1 second to 2 seconds. I still personally find this gadget to be much less helpful than his tuning fork gadget, but maybe it'll end up being the better choice if you're facing a brawler that you know is going to be dealing a lot of status effects like Frank in Power League, for example. Mortis is getting a very interesting change. The effect from his coiled snake star power is now going to be permanently applied to Mortis, even if you don't have coiled snake. This means that if Mortis has a full ammo, after a short charge up, his next attack will actually increase in range pretty significantly, even if you don't have coiled snake. With that said, it will take 1 second longer to charge up than before the update. And to make up for that, Mortis's coiled snake star power is getting reworked so that it will decrease the required charging time by 1.5 seconds. In other words, before the update, it took 3.5 seconds to charge. After the update, it will charge in 4.5 seconds. And with coiled snake after the update, it will charge in 3 seconds. And you guys can see a comparison right here to give you an idea of what to expect after the update. Honestly, I think there is a very good argument to start using his creepy harvest star power, because that star power got a ton of buffs to try and make it competitive with coiled snake. In fact, I actually wouldn't be surprised at all if Mortis was about to become meta in the competitive scene. Maybe not like crazy strong in the meta, but definitely more viable. Next we have Shelly, whose Clay Pigeon's gadget is getting a much needed rework. After she activates it, any ammo that she fires for the next 5 seconds will have their range extended significantly. If Shelly starts out with full ammo, it is possible for her to unload 5 shots in those 5 seconds, which will greatly increase this gadget's effectiveness. I'm still not convinced that it will make Shelly competitive in higher trophies, but she might be less annoying to grind quests with, at least, so at least she's got that going for her. Then again, her other gadget works really well with her. Jean is getting 1 buff and 2 nerfs. First of all, the damage from his homing missile's gadget is increasing from 800 to 1000 damage. That is a 25% damage buff, and I'm still not actually convinced it's going to be enough to make me want to use it. However, his lamp blowout gadget is getting nerfed so that it will no longer heal Jean unless it actually knocks a brawler back. I personally use Jean's lamp blowout gadget more often for its knockback than for its heal, although the heal was nice, and I imagine that I'm still going to prefer Lamp Blowout. However, I might not be playing Jean very much after this update because his attack damage is getting an 11% nerf. At max level, his attack damage is decreasing from 1,512 to 1,344 damage. This means that Jean will require one more ammo to take out 19 of the 50 brawlers in the game. That is a very significant change, especially because Jean will no longer be able to 3-shot brawlers over 4,100 HP. Now let's talk about the other brawlers that are getting nerfs. El Primo's supercharge rate from his attack is getting a 78% nerf. In other words, his supercharge will require 16 hits instead of only 9, which is what it was before balance changes. That means that with each full attack that El Primo hits on an enemy, his super will only charge by 25%. It also means that in order for him to cycle supers or recycle them, he will have to land on an enemy with a super and unload 3 full ammo on them in order to recharge his super. El Primo does benefit from his supercharging when he takes damage, but this is a very significant nerf to him, and I have a feeling we're going to be seeing a lot less El Primo after the update. Next is Belle, whose shielding from her positive feedback star power is decreasing from 25% shielding to 20% shielding. This is a very small nerf, and I expect that most people will continue to use her positive feedback star power over her grounded star power. I could be wrong though, but the immediate visible benefits from this shield is just too good to pass up, even if it's only 20%. Stu is getting 3 nerfs. First of all, his breakthrough gadget is now going to require a charged super in order for him to activate. That means that he will no longer get a free super just for tapping that gadget. And this will make it a bit harder for him to shape the terrain by breaking down walls. However, Stu will still have plenty of opportunities because it's really easy for him to charge a super in the first place. Now his breakthrough gadget is getting another nerf, but this time to its damage. The damage that debris will deal from him breaking through walls is decreasing from 500 damage per debris down to 200 damage, which is pretty significant. Now on top of that, the healing that his Gasso Heal star power gives him is reducing from 500 to 400 healing per super. Stu has honestly been crazy for a really long while, and I think that these changes will definitely tone him down a bit. I know that I said in my title that he is bad, and I don't actually think that he's completely bad. I think he'll actually still be good, especially in the hands of the right player. He just won't be as strong, which is what I'm really looking forward to, because I honestly tried to ban Stu in Power League every single time I could. Nani's return to sender gadget is getting a decent nerf. It is now going to expire if Nani does not take damage within 5 seconds of activating this gadget. That means that you'll want to activate the gadget at the right time, because if enemies see that that shield is just floating around Nani, they can just wait until that gadget disappears so that they don't end up taking damage. I really like this gadget change because it will still allow for some really epic plays while also requiring some skill on the user. Sandy's Sweet Dreams gadget is getting a bit of a nerf. The duration of the sleep is decreasing from 1.5 seconds to 1 second. I still think this gadget will be pretty strong, since a stun like that is always useful. I think I honestly underestimated how strong this gadget would be, and that's even true if the stun gets interrupted by damage. I still think this will be the gadget of choice for Sandy, but we'll see how this ends up holding up. Next is Rico, whose bouncing castle healing is decreasing from 300 to 250 healing per bounce. This means that if Rico wants to fully heal himself from almost zero, he'll still need each projectile to bounce 3 times. But in this case, he won't actually end up overhealing himself like before. I still think that this gadget will be strong and definitely the preferred gadget for Rico even after its nerf. Next is actually a change to Heist. The safe's HP is increasing by a whopping 25%. That means that if everybody is playing a level 10 brawler, the health is increasing from 45,000 to 56,000 HP. That's an 11,000 HP buff, which means that heist matches will definitely last longer on average. Also, the supercharge trait for tanks is now going to be based on a brawler's max health. So that means that it equalizes the effectiveness of it at all power levels. I don't actually think this will change very much at max level, but for brawlers that are like level 6 or something like that, it will be a significant improvement for them. Now, unless Supercell makes some last minute changes, those are all the balance changes coming in the update. I'm really curious to know what you guys thought about these balance changes. Is there a brawler that you're looking forward to trying? Maybe Mortis or Squeak. I'm really looking forward to playing both of those. Maybe there's a brawler that you thought should have been buffed, or maybe even possibly nerfed. Let me know in the comment section below, and make sure you guys subscribe for more sneak peeks. You just tap that right there, hit that notification bell so you don't miss anything, and then you can check out some other videos right there. And don't forget to use code Kairos in the Brawl Stars shop. And for now, this is Kairos time ticking by, and we will see you guys in the next Brawl Stars sneak peek. That's what it is.